today's draft, NFL players who would make the best wrestling stars. A little WWE crossover. Chris, I'll give you the first pick.
Okay, all right. I'm cheating on this one too, just so you know. I'm cheating. It's creativity.
Why?
Time. Because I'm going with a tag team duo right off the bat. Screw
Go
you.
Go ahead.
That's what
Go
I'm
ahead.
Doing.
I don't care.
It's called the Brown Brothers. The Brown Towers, whatever you want to call them. Trent Brown, Orlando Brown Jr. I want size with my wrestling. I want pure intimidation. When the music starts and WWE time comes and they walk out of that tunnel onto that black ramp, I want the two biggest humans on earth, okay, to come out. And that's where I go, Trent Brown, Orlando Brown Jr., thank you. You know, I mean, they can literally, like, the guys, whoever they're playing, they are fighting against, they can just go, well, we can beat you to oblivion and smother you, or we could eat you. Anything you want, we could do. We're gigantic. I mean, that's like almost 700 pounds of man right there. I mean, I just don't know if a tag team duo could be beat like that.
Here's the question. Are they good guys or are they heels?
Oh, I think they're bad guys. I think they gotta be mean bad guys. Trent Brown, he's a jerk and doesn't want to play for anybody but the New England Patriots. And Orlando Brown Jr. he's a left tackle. Trade me, Baltimore.
Well, I tell you, you left the most obvious guy on the board. I can't ignore the guy who already has held of the WWE belts, Gronk. How can it not be Gronk?
He was
the 24/7 champion, which I didn't even know was a thing. Apparently, if you're the 24/7 champion, anytime a camera is around, if someone pins you, you lose the belt anywhere you may be. He held it for a while. I think he was pinned in his backyard or something like that. But Gronk, that just seems to be where he's destined to go whenever this unretirement from football ends.
Right. Well, I agreed. He fits right, you know, in the mold, definitely. I mean, and we know he likes taking his shirt off and dancing and doing all that in front of people anyways. So I don't disagree with that. I'll just go with a guy that I think, you know, is more in the prime that way. Another tight end, George Kittle. I think he's probably the second most obvious guy in the whole NFL as far as that's concerned. You know, just his attitude. He acts like a wrestler. I mean, when we see him all the time, that's who he is. So he has the energy, the showmanship, the craziness about him for me all the way. So George Kittle is where I'll go there.
I tell you, Kittle was on my list. He's got that energy. He would be awesome. But how have we gotten this deep into the draft without J.J. Watt and or the Watt brothers? Forget about tag team.
Yes, I know.
Let's go three. J.J., T.J., D.J. Get them all out there. I know he prefers Derek to D.J., but we'll call him D.J. They're the Watt trio. And I could see J.J. like he would be the superstar, the hero, and then at the right moment he takes a turn to heel and becomes anti-American.
Oh, never.
Gets everybody all riled up.
He would never do that.
for enough money. It's all acting. And then you turn back the other way. You have your redemption. You were brainwashed. So the Watt trio
okay,
would take over the wrestling world.
I like that because I'm going back to a tag team duo too here. I'm going with the Bosa brothers. All right, the Bosa brothers. To me, I mean, I could just picture them have like either tied up like, you know, the Ultimate Warrior with like strings on their arms and guns and veins popping out. You know, and I could also picture them both being like, oh, yeah, and putting the ear out there, doing all that. Who do you think wins? Tag team comp between the Bosa brothers and let's take Derek Watt out of that and T.J. Watt and J.J. Ooh. Watt. Ooh, baby, that would be a good one. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
I know.
Well, whoever the writers decide would win. That would be who would win. Right.
Yes. Whoever the writers.
Right.
Yes. Right.
Whatever script works out better for that night, that's who would win it. Last one for me. And this is more manager, because that's one thing about, I don't know, I haven't watched it much lately, but back in the 80s, it was the golden age of the managers. Classy Freddie Blassie.
Yeah.
Bobby the Brain.
Oh, my God.
Heenan. The little guy with the mullet and the glasses, the skinny guy, Jimmy something.
Oh,
I can't remember.
That used to be with the Million
name.
Dollar Man, that guy?
Yeah.
He was with him? Yeah, right.
Was it Jimmy Hart? I don't know.
I think it was. Yeah.
Jimmy's getting upset. But anyway, I got to go Rex and Rob Ryan. right? They'd be the Lou Albanos of today. And there's two of them. And you could just see that one of them would sneak a chair to the other one, and he'd get up on the apron, and he'd slap someone with the chair. Or
definitely,
like, he would try to hit somebody else. And
definitely,
Rex would punch Rob, and Rob would do a face plant. So the Ryan twins as the managers for one of these other tag team combinations.
Oh, I could see that for sure. Rex talking to the referee while Rob goes that back behind his back and, you know, like you said, gets the tree or gets the chair or the table and smashes it on somebody. Yeah, I mean, you went down this wrestling wormhole, you know, last night, you know, on text. You sent us some text messages and stuff, so you're all in on the WWE, baby.
Let me say this. For anyone out there who is inclined to complain in any way, shape, or form about the quality of NFL officiating, the referees in the WWE are among the most incompetent, intentionally incompetent, that you could ever imagine. Missing all sorts of cheating, foreign objects, canes, chairs.
Oh, they never
anything and everything
see it.
Goes.
Never.
As soon as their back conveniently turns,
right,
all hell breaks loose.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.